midst of a dark time in the feudal age, one man devoted his life to public duty. He was Jung Yagyong, the greatest Chilhak philosopher in Korean history. Jung Yagyong was a great intellectual, admired teacher, and loving father, whose teachings have been passed down for 200 years. At a relatively young age, he became a renowned scholar. He passed the royal state exam in his teens and received an enviable government position. Although he was one of King Jeongjo's most trusted ministers, he was sent into exile midway through his career. He spent 18 years in exile based on charges that he was involved in Western learning, which were brought against him in the aftermath of the Shinyusaok incident where Roman Catholics were persecuted. Teacher Hwang Juho has taught the Korean language for 18 years. He's always strived to be a better teacher. Jung Yagyong continued to teach students during his years in exile. Hwang Sang was a student of Jung Yagyong's who asked a pointed question at the age of 15.
"제가 세 가지 병통이 있습니다. 첫째는 둔해서 머리가 나쁜 것이고, 둘째는 앞뒤가 꽉 막힌 것이고, 셋째는 분별력이 모자란 것입니다. 이런 제가 공부를 할 수 있겠습니까?"
"둔하지만 공부에 파고든 자는 식견이 넓어지고, 막혔지만 잘 뚫는 자는 흐름이 거세지며, 미혹하지만 잘 닦는 자는 빛이 난다."
Hwang Sang was uneducated, but Jung Yagyong saw his potential and taught enthusiastically. Jung Yagyong believed that everyone should have an equal opportunity to receive an education, since the field of study could be learned and applied by anyone. Pursuing the spirit of Jung Yagyong, a teacher who was dedicated to spreading education. Teacher Hwang Juho has been holding book discussion meetings for 13 years. These meetings aim for equal opportunities and nurtured talent, which was what Jung Yagyong wanted.
자기 자리에서 남들에게 도움되는 그런 삶, 실천하면서 살아가는 삶, 그게 정말로 행복한 삶 아니겠습니까?
He wishes to truly teach his students about life. Like Jung Yagyong, he also believes that practicing what you learn in your life is important.
공부는 방심을 구하는 것, 그것뿐이다.
다 선생님은 남들의 눈을 튀고 남들의 지식을 튀어주는 그런 일을 했지 않습니까? 그와 마찬가지로 정말 남들에게 좀 도움이 되는 그런 삶을 살았으면 하는 것이 제 그 학생들을 가르치는 그런 이상이고 꿈입니다.
He helps his students find direction in their lives. It is a huge responsibility to nurture people and guide them towards a purposeful life. Let us learn the duty of a teacher through Jung Yagyong's teachings.
Elected as the new county governor just 3 months ago, he holds the highest office in Hamad. His actions have a direct impact on the people. He reads the book Mokmin Shimso, written by Jong Yagyong. During his time in exile, Jong Yagyong thought deeply about the political system and how it should serve the people. He was able to see firsthand the hardships and struggles of poor and disenfranchised commoners in his place of exile. He formed a strong belief that effective reforms to benefit people could only be carried out by qualified public servants. He proposed numerous plans for improving the lives of the poor. A new set of civil rights principles which gives power into the hands of the people. Mogwi Minyu represented Jong Yagyong's political beliefs. In the same vein as Jong Yagyong's policies that provided tangible benefits to people, County Governor Ha Song-shik is transforming the county administration into an effective force. He also follows Jong Yagyong's teachings by listening to the grievances of the poor. According to the teachings that a public official must be clean and honest, County Governor Ha Song-shik vowed to shun money politics and create a clean administration. A public office holder must serve the people, as Jong Yagyong said. A 200-year-old message rings through the heart. He can hardly remember the last time he had a conversation with his son.
일단은 저도 바쁘고 아이는 컸다고 자기 시간을 저한테 양보 안 하고 그러다 보니까 거의 없어요, 저희는.
How can he reestablish a close father-son relationship? He's going to resolve the problem today. Jong Yagyong had two sons. Let us learn the wisdom he imparted to us in his writings. Due to the many years he spent in exile, he was separated from his two sons. But he maintained contact with his sons by writing hundreds of letters to them. He communicated with them through letters. Jong Yagyong was reunited with his eldest son after 7 years of separation and was greatly relieved to find that he had grown into a fine boy despite his absence. His son was able to find stability thanks to his father's letters. Writing may be the best way to articulate deep thoughts.
Let us learn the importance of communication between parents and their children.
참 아이한테 내가 못된 아버지였구나라는 생각도 들었고 참 아이한테 미안한 마음이 들더라고요. 그래서 이렇게 편지를 쓰면서 아이를 다시 한번 이렇게 되돌아볼 수 있는 다시 이렇게 내 아이구나, 내 사랑하는 아들이구나라는 것을 한번 깊이 깨닫는 그런 좋은 시간이 되었던 것 같습니다.
The communication between father and son is slowly improving. Jongyakyong dedicated his life to synthesizing Neo-Confucian thought and completing the principles of Shilhak. As an educator, he taught his students by example, and through his scholarly works, he influenced a great number of people. Transcending time, the teachings of Jongyakyong have endured for more than two centuries, and they are drawn from his life experiences that now give other people direction in their lives.